that actually I keep saying princes. That's a conventional translation for the word knyazi. So my argument is that knyazi stood for the group that combined royalty and aristocracy. That some knyazi were like lords, but others had the position of the king. And contrary to the popular perception, late 12th century Kievan princes were, by the standard of the time, pretty powerful kings. That actually their amount, the degree of their authority over regional princes, and the extent of their responsibilities made them efficient monarchs. And the fact that the Suzdalian princes also had a similar position, and the fact that they had Suzdalian princes, Kievan princes, had a lot of overlapping jurisdictions and powers, and they managed it through a complex system of agreements and occasional military conflicts, does not disqualify them from being like normal medieval kings, because the notion of sovereign state, of sovereign ruler, did not exist in medieval Europe. That's how relations between the kings were. A lot of overlapping, a lot of mutual agreements, a lot of conflicts, and kind of it's never clear who exactly controls what. So in this case, Rus was like normal European kingdom. Okay, yes, he argued that knyaz should be translated as king. But, you know, in this case, okay, Kievan prince, yes, actually should be known as king. Suzdalian prince in the later 12th century, yes. Polotsk prince, yes, for sure. But if we always translate knyaz as king, actually there will be like a bunch of kings. Some of them would rule like, you know, a tiny wooden fortress and a couple of miles around this fortress. Would you think about this as a kingdom?